Morning, my name is Yodia Shim and I'll be going over the impacts of the opinions of parents and coaches on the mental health of youth athletes. My question was, to what extent has the opinions of parents and coaches impacted the mental health of youth athletes in the United States for the past 20 years? My claim is, the opinions of sports specialization, high expectations, and winning that have been placed by parents and coaches has negatively impacted the mental health of many youth athletes. One factor that impacts the mental health of youth athletes is sports specialization. Some parents believe that their child or children have an outstanding physical ability compared to other athletes. When they believe that their child should pursue a sports career, pressures place on them, creating parental stress. In the Science Journal, a review of early sports specialization in relation to the development of a young athlete, sports specialization, especially early sports specialization, have an adverse psychological impact on increased stress to become an elite player, which can lead to high rates of attrition, overemphasis on winning, and inappropriate expectations. Along with high levels of stress, the risk of a psychological burnout is extremely high. In the article, The Negative Effects of Sports Specialization on Youth-Aged Athletes, it states that youth athletes are getting pushed and pulled from all different directions on what they should be doing with their lives as they're being pushed to specialize all year around. Youth athletes are forced to reach a fantasy set up by coaches and parents, harming their mental health in the process. In the table provided from NCAA, only 791 participants out of 36,011 participants were drafted, and only 9.9% out of the 791 will go major pro. This shows that only a few number of youth athletes actually play professionally in the future. Roosevelt also says that sports career should not be at a greater focus than academics, since the risk of being late is high. Another factor is high and unrealistic expectations. When parents and coaches think that the youth athlete is good at playing a sport, they start to expect things from them, creating intense pressure on the athlete. They start to expect more than what the youth athlete can actually achieve, which creates an increase in anxiety and nervousness, increased stress, and creates low self-esteem. In the report, Why Children Youth Drop Out of Sports, it is stated that anxiety and nervousness can arise in youth athletes due to their fear of making mistakes in games. In the article, Youth Sport: Positive and Negative Impact on Young Athletes, it states that a parent can inadvertently set a child up for failure by establishing unrealistic goals for performance and winning by forcing a youth athlete to participate in sports beyond their readiness and interest. When the youth athlete is unable to perform as expected, by parents and coaches, they may lose confidence and seek alternative ways to have fun. The last factor I found was overemphasis on winning. According to the article, Youth Sport: Positive and Negative Impact on Young Athletes, sports satisfaction surveys revealed that having fun is the main reason that most children participate in sports. However, some parents think that their child plays sports because they like to win. This mix of fun and winning can create misunderstanding and negative effects. The overemphasis of winning can cause youth athletes to lose interest in playing a sport and, or as I said earlier, lose confidence if they cannot reach certain expectations such as winning. Instead of heavily emphasizing competition and winning, emphasizing a child-friendly atmosphere and achievable expectations with an emphasis on fundamental skills development and joy is important. However, there are some benefits to the pressure that parents and coaches generate. Most youth athletes start a sport because of their own interest or because their parents suggest or encourage them to play. The article Teen Sport in America: Why Participation Matters, it was reported that those who play at least one sport have a higher self-esteem than those who does not participate in a sport. In the scientific report, parental involvement in youth sports and examination of Team Greenville. An interviewed parent says, I have seen swimmers finish dead last and be thrilled because they dropped 3 seconds from their personal best. The pressure given off by coaches and parents to do their best and strive to win can influence youth athletes to do their best in everything, even if they fail to reach their goal. My solution to the issue is parents and coaches should refrain from pressuring their children to specialize in sports. Expectations should match what the youth athlete can actually perform, and winning should not be the main goal in the sport. While these may seem simple, it is hard since it is not watched by an organization or someone can actually watch every coach or parent to actually fulfill this. Instead, it would have to be done with their own will, and if these were to be kept, the mental health of youth athletes would improve, allowing them to perform better in sports as well as academically. In conclusion, opinions of parents and coaches that negatively impact the mental health of youth athletes include pressure into sports specialization, higher than realistic expectations, over emphasis on winning. Thank you.
Two questions I have for you. First up, how valid and reliable were the sources you used, and how do you know they were?
I know my sources were valid because most of them were from scientists or those who actually studied and looked at what psychological impacts there were on many athletes.
And what advice would you have for other researchers who want to look at this topic in the future?
Advice I would give is to have a target audience. For me, I didn't specify enough, so advice I would give is to specify which gender, like male youth athletes or female or transgender. And I would say to not just look at psychological impacts, not like opinions of parents, but also the physical injuries that can also cause psychological.